Is any coherence worth the celebration? Okay. I look at the few flowers set amid the handsome withered weeds, potted and heated, Carolee made into a collage, no, a bouquet, yesterday, at the precise moment of our arrival. Few light violet or white field daisies fading among all that dead and drying meadow summer. What might it be, the coherence? If it's worth celebrating at all, it's worth celebrating. Well, the camera never lies, so I record. An empty chair with sandals sitting in front of it, a cat under a bush, a Bob with his hair slicked down, Carolee sitting, leaning against the front of the house of glass, curled as the cat is curled, smiling as the cat does not smile, being held all that afternoon in the dead, drying meadow of summer, the sense of all our bodies, the flesh of our bodies almost marginal. The weeds are handsomer dead than the living flowers. In the morning before the house wakes, I read my friend's poems and drink his yesterday's coffee reheated, seated at kitchen table, sit facing the east windows wearing sunglasses. Brilliance of the poem shining in the jungle of objects in the sun when the sun, brilliant at 10 o'clock high, is rubbed out in a rumble with cloud. I am not surprised. The gray-green softness is my element. See and contemplate the cup, the fish between my legs and its mutilated relationships with the freshets of this world. The body as I sit, legs spread beneath the robe opening, is central in the eye, not marginal, not how one hand rests on the book to go back. Change my glasses at 10:05 to continue reading the strict breaking coherences of my friend's poems to celebrate Sunday, to hear, see how he tears them out of his rich flesh. December 6th and 7th. The news keeps squirting in from all over. It's like a leak in my head. The two astronauts in Gemini 7 took a snapshot of a Polaris missile yesterday, shot from a nuclear sub parked near the Cape. Co-pilot Commander James Lovell cried as the missile broke water, "We got her, we got her, she's beautiful," sitting there in his underwear. Somewhere around the 30th orbit, he had climbed out of his spacesuit. The first zippers he unzipped somewhere around the Canary Islands, 40 minutes and 11,000 miles later over Madagascar, he'd gotten down to his long johns. "I feel naked," he said, "and also, it's the only way to fly." Frank Borman was supposed to get undressed later. I never heard what happened. But what a great idea, a pair of astronauts orbiting Earth for 2 full weeks in their underwear. What happens when they get horny? "Hey, Jimmy, I see you got a heart on." "All right, Frankie boy, you want to do something about it?" And Frank cuts off the blood pressure, telemetry, pulse, respiration, and so forth. And as far as Houston's concerned, they're dead. Imagine what happens when they start sending ladies up. Coeducational orbiting, wow. Oh, the headlines, love at first flight. And the usual housekeeping chores. Meanwhile, back at the pad, Gemini 6 is being readied for liftoff, scheduled this Sunday, the 12th. Walter Schirra and Tom Stafford are to try to effect a rendezvous with the other two boys. And in Miami, Representative Walter H. Miller, Ohio, an ordained Lutheran minister and a member of the House Space Committee on vacation, protested the launching of the spacecraft on Sunday. "In these days of crisis," he said, "we need all the moral and spiritual resources we can muster." I'm surprised he didn't complain about the underwear. Well, I'm about to the end of the broadcast. High tides for today, December 7th, Sandy Hook, 6:20 a.m., 6:46 p.m., 6:33 a.m., 7:07 p.m. on the north side of Montauk Point. At the Battery, 649 and 712. Temperatures yesterday were various. 88 degrees and clear in Kingston, Jamaica. 84 degrees and cloudy in Acapulco. 85 and partly cloudy in San Juan. 41 degrees and cloudy in Paris. 59 in Rome. 52 degrees and clear in Athens. 36 and snow in Moscow. 84 degrees and cloudy in Saigon. In Copenhagen, 34 degrees and snow. 57 and partly cloudy in both Cairo and Tunis. Aldebaran's very bright to the east at sunset. Altair and Vega in the west at the same hour, 4:29. 7:30 p.m., Mars reddish low in the west, an hour earlier. Again at sunset, 4:29. Jupiter is very bright to the east and Saturn likewise in the southwest. And tomorrow, December 8th, the moon is full. And on Saturday, December 11th, the home lines announce a 4 p.m. sailing of the Oceanic from Pier 84 at 44th Street, North River, which is listed in the ship's schedules as cruise to nowhere. Don't miss it. Don't miss it, boys and girls, and that's all for tonight.